Hello everyone. Today is Tuesday, November 7th, 2023 at 12:10 p.m. They're making me yawn. I didn't have to yawn before during this video. So they hit me with director energy weapons to make me either yawn, cough, or clear my throat, or make my nose itch or something. So excuse me. It seems like I needed to psychologically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually and physically recuperate. I guess I'm feeling a little bit better physically, but this morning I woke up, my legs are still hurting, but the swelling went down, and I slept better last night and the night before, but I'm still feeling sleep deprived from previous nights of little to no sleep. So one person was concerned about me having congestive heart failure, and a couple of other people thought I was diabetic. I have none of those as issues. And so yesterday the doctor told me that everything came back fine or normal, but like when they did the x-rays on me yesterday, from the moment that they started with the x-rays and up until the time I got in the Uber and left out of the hospital, my right eye was twitching really bad, like muscle, muscles. I don't know if it's the nerves or muscles in my eyes, I'm not sure, which kept twitching. And I think that was directed energy weapons as well. So, you know, I'm glad I didn't have the worst experience. I'm glad I did not have the worst experience, you know, at this hospital. They had a lot of bad reviews and low reviews on Google, but I took a risk. But I guess, I mean, the nurse was a little rude, and the paramedics were kind of unhelpful. And they came at precisely 10:33 in the morning, which was Masonic 33, so I knew they were perps. And it's so sick and disgusting if you have a medical emergency and they perp you even worse while you're in a medical emergency. So before yesterday, the gang stalking network or whoever, I was being attacked by them or drones or whatever. Whether it be gang stalkers, drones, something or somebody was attacking me in my heart, on the right side of my heart, excuse me, and causing like burning feeling in my heart. And see, I did not mean to do that, but I guess it was exactly at the 3 minute and 33 second mark, or right before that, when they made me cough again. Excuse me. So, like, tomorrow I have to check out of this hotel room. My socks were so used up that I had to throw my socks away. My pants got holes in them. I only got this outfit. I had to get that new phone, and this new phone right here. So I feel broke already, you know. And winter is coming soon, and it's so cold-blooded and evil that people harass you and gang stalk you out of your home and set you up and to be forced to be homeless. Excuse me. And the fake Darnell Williams perp, he had falsely reported videos yesterday and today, and on TikTok, and TikTok keeps rejecting all of my appeals. Even after they recently restored my account, and now they're rejecting all of my appeals. This is not right at all. So me showing proof and footage of the gang stalking, the sleep deprivation, the effects of everything, all the harassment and everything. You keep falsely reporting everything as misinformation. They're creating more lies, false rumors, slander. My twin sister has been bullying, harassing, and threatening me and ganging up with the sex traffickers against me and threatening to get a gag order against me and falsely accusing me of doing voodoo on her. And it's like, I'm sitting here being targeted and fighting for my survival and just have my backpack. I have no way to, and I don't even have the knowledge to do voodoo on anybody, but I really think that she's a narcissistic perp using projection. I mean, I already know she's a narcissistic perp using projection, but I really think that she's doing voodoo on me and making up just lies, keep on making up more lies. And she threatened to get a gag order on me. And, you know, the fact that I exposed that she sold her soul to the devil, she's trying to make it like, oh, it's none of my business. But you're destroying my life. And teaming up with internet strangers to ruin your own twin sister. And I'm not going to shut up. So, I mean, this morning I'm feeling extremely depressed, like emotionally very depressed, and professed targeted individuals, you know, going against me left and right, but I'm surprised that I still have a few little small amount of people for support still. Excuse me. But it's like, how you block me for no reason on social media, but then you cry and complain about being isolated and slandered, and then you turn around and do the same to another person that's a fellow TI. That got me all kinds of confused. Excuse me. So, I still got this mucus in my throat and the tooth abscess. And the Tourette's and stuff is all the reason for my coughing and clearing throat. And I'm just still really depressed and been sad and crying more often. And, you know, like I'm sitting here feeling like, for political reasons, everybody got a whole bunch of money to donate to other countries or donate to foreign people. But, you know, you spit in the face of fellow homeless, your fellow Americans. Or you would donate to and help out animals more than humans. But, you know, excuse me. I have been too depressed to work on any writings. I've been physically fatigued and tired, too deprived, and have not been able to work on any writing. Still can't get a physical address or a mailing address in order to get my Louisiana my driver's license switched back. And I haven't been in this situation, and my homeless situation is even worse. So it's like, am I going to be dealing with swollen legs and fluid in my heart every week? And people just don't value my life. People don't value my life at all. They ignore and pass me up. And I'm trying as best as I could to keep myself up, trying to keep clean or do hygiene or, you know, it's hard to try to improve things when you're homeless. When I had the place to live, you know, I really miss cooking and I wanted to improve cooking skills and make cooking videos in addition to writing and have more streams of income, trying to get Ticket to Work. The gang stalking network, they ruin everything I try to accomplish. They ought to be the ones out here homeless, or they need to be jailed or in prison. I didn't deserve this, and I'm just being attacked and sabotaged and persecuted all day, every day, without a break. And I don't know how much more I can take. I need any and all the help I can get.